When we are sailing on shallow or unfamiliar waters, we should take a few precautions. We should first of all sail very, very slowly, the minimum speed required to take the boat under control forwards. We should have someone at the bow giving us a heads up on any change of the color of the water, and preferably having someone reading out the numbers of the echo sounder. It is very important to brief the guy at the bow to hold on to something in case the boat comes to a complete stop immediately. The most important and immediate thing to do once the boat hits the ground is to stop the propulsion, the forward movement. We do it by putting the engine into neutral if we're under engine, and luffing out the sails and lowering them down if we're under sails. First thing we do is putting the engine into neutral position. Then we start the damage control. First thing to check is that the crew is okay. The boat came to a complete stop after sailing, so people may have fallen down or hit something. Then we start with the damage control of the boat itself. We're going down below and lift up the floor panels to make sure that there is no water entrance or any damages in the connection of the keel to the boat. We check the rudder and we check for water outlet. It will be wise to check on the tide. If the water are rising up, it will be easier to get off the ground, assuming that the wind is not pushing us more and more towards the shallow waters. If the water are lowering down, it will be wise to get out of there as soon as possible. So first thing we do in order to get the boat off after we saw that the boat is fine and not damaged is putting the boat in reverse, trying to use the power of the engine to get off the ground. If we found out that we cannot take the boat off the ground by using the power of the engine only, we better decrease the draft of the boat by tilting it. We will do that by putting some weight on the boom and taking the boom out as far as possible off the center of the boat. Since there is going to be a lot of weight on the boom, we need to secure it so we don't put all our trust on the topping lift. We can use the main halyard and tie it to secure the boom as well. We want to make a railing or a lifeline for the crew members to clip themselves to while climbing on the boom. So we do that by attaching a line from the topping lift parallel to the boom and to the mast. In order to prevent the boom from swinging, we'll use a preventer attached from the end of the boom towards the forward cleat. The crew member is securing himself to the line attached from the topping lift to the mast and climbing up on the boom and start moving towards the end of it. The added weight off the center of the boat will cause the boat to heel, and by that decreasing the draft. Having all the weight possible gathered to the same side will increase the heeling. Another option is to use the main sheet tackle to lift something heavy off the water. A dinghy will be something good to use. The greater the heel will be, the lower the draft will be, and it will be easier to get off the ground. Once the boat is back afloat, there is a change in the pressures and the efforts that are working on the hull. It will be wise to make an extra damage control and checking especially the bolts attaching the keel to the boat now. Sunglasses with polarized lens give an easier view into the water. You can actually see deeper into the water using those glasses.